हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल आरएसके कॉम्पिटिटिव वर्ल्ड। स्टूडेंट्स, आफ्टर वाचिंग दिस वीडियो प्लीज गिव द लाइक एंड शेयर टू योर फ्रेंड्स। सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट द ट्रांजिस्टर नेक्स्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, दैट इज व्हाट फीडबैक। सो व्हाट इज मीन बाय फीडबैक? द फीडबैक इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ टेकिंग अ पार्ट ऑफ आउटपुट सिग्नल ऑफ सम डिवाइसेस, फीडिंग इट बैक टू द इनपुट सर्किट और द सिग्नल इज नोन एज फीडबैक। सो व्हाट इज फीडबैक? द प्रोसेस ऑफ taking a part of output signal. When we given to the input signal to the circuit, we get the output values. That part of output signal is feeding back it to the again input signal is known as a feedback. So it is what a feedback, and now it can be found very useful in reducing noise in amplifiers, and also making the amplifier operations. So feedback is what? A process of taking a part of a signal, feeding it back to the input signal is known as feedback, and it is used to reducing the noise in the amplifiers and making the amplifier operations. So in this case, there are two types of feedbacks are there. So first one is what? Positive feedback. So the second one is negative feedback. So let us discuss about the first type, that is what? Positive feedback. So positive feedback is what? When the feedback signal input or the voltage current, input voltage or the current, and the part of the output signal which are in phase with each other is known as a positive feedback. Let us study the points, that is output signal is in phase with input signal. What is the first point? Positive feedback means what? Output signal is in phase with the input signal. And the second one is what? Input signal and feedback signal, whatever you are taking from the output, that is what? A feedback signal. The part of output signal is what? Feedback signal. Both are gets added. The input signal and the feedback signal gets added. The first one is output signal is in phase with the input signal. The second one is input signal and the feedback signal gets added. So due to addition of the signal, we get, that is what? This is called as a regenerative feedback or direct feedback. So when the part of the output signal is fed into the input signal, means what? There will be input signal and the feedback signals will get added, which is known as a regenerative feedback or the direct feedback. Because of this one, the input signal will be increases. Input voltage increases. When the part of the output signal is fed into the input signal, the input voltage should be increases. This is about the positive feedback. So here we have to study the what is the positive feedback there is by using the circuit. So let us study about the circuit diagram of this positive feedback. So this is amplifier. So the input Vi is given input so this is a output V naught so which is the out part of the output signal is fed into the input signal this is what a feedback network feedback gain so this is the input signal the input is given to the amplifier and after amplification we will get the output value here this part of the output is given fed into the input signal then the input signal gets added means it gets added means the input voltage should be increases here so this is the when the part of the output is given to the input signal means what that is feedback voltage that is what feedback voltage so this is the feedback network amplifier this is a feedback network So here, if the signal is given, that is what here. If the signal is given to the input here, introducing 180 degree phase shift. Introducing 180 degree phase shift means the output should be like this, opposite to the input. Introducing the 180 degree phase shift. The output should be like this. So the part of the output is fed back to the input means which is known as feedback voltage. So here there is a introducing 180 degree phase shift means this output should be opposite. If you given the signal like this means introducing 180 degree phase shift means the signal should be opposite direction. Okay and again introducing 180 degree phase shift means the value the signal is here after introducing 180 degree to this value the signal again the same as it is of the input signal means these both are in phase with each other the input signal and the output signal which are in phase with each other so which is known as a positive feedback when the input signal is given to the amplifier we'll get the output signal here so if the part of this output signal is fed into the input signal here there is a input signal which is vi which is equal to vin plus vf this is what input signal plus feedback voltage the input signal The previous input signal should be only VIN. Okay. Next, after getting the part of this output is fed into the input means what? VI is equal to VIN plus VF means which should be added. So the output signal should be increases. Output signal should be increases. Increases. Okay. So this is about the positive feedback in this positive feedback increases the gain of an amplifier and it has a and one important use of positive feedback is used in oscillators okay which is used in oscillators and it has a one disadvantage that increased distortion and instability What is the disadvantage? Increased disadvantage Disadvantage is what? Increased distortion. Distortion and instability. Increased distortion and instability. This is the one disadvantage here, and if it is used to in oscillators and gain of an amplifier, and which increases the output values, this is the positive feedback. The second one is what? A negative feedback. Negative feedback. So what is mean by negative feedback? The negative feedback is when the feedback signal input current or voltage, when the feedback signal input current or voltage, input signal current or voltage, and part of output signal, input signal and the output signal, which are out of phase. In positive feedback, what happens? The input signal and the output signal, which are in phase. But in the negative feedback, the input signal and the output signal are, which are out of phase. So, which is known as degenerative feedback. Degenerative amplifier or the degenerative feedback. Degenerative feedback, and which reduces the input voltage, which are out of phase, means which reduces the input voltage, which is known as negative feedback. Let us study about the circuit diagram here. So, the circuit diagram for negative feedback is what? When the input is given to the amplifier, so the output signal is formed, that is what output here, and the part of the input is fed back to the, which is passing through the feedback network, and which is given to the input. This is input Vi, and the feedback voltage given from the part of the output is given to the voltage is given to the input, means this is the feedback voltage. How much the part of the voltage given to the feedback means what? Which is decided by the feedback network. How much we have to give the output fed into the input, that is decided by the feedback network. So here in the negative feedback, what happens? The output signal and the input signal are out of phase, which is known as a degenerative amplifier. So, because of this degenerative, input voltage will be reduces. How it will be reduces? See here. There is introducing, first the signal is what? The signal is given to the amplifier. After the amplification, we will give a output voltage here. So, introducing 180 degree phase shift. Introducing 180 degree phase shift to the amplifier, and we get the output voltage inverting. Okay, we get the output voltage inverting because 180 degree phase shift we given to the amplifier. This input signal should be opposes, and the signal getting inverted. Okay, and which this is the part of this output is given fed into the input, means here introducing 0 degree phase shift. The feedback network introducing the 0 degree phase shift means what happens? If there is a no change in the signal, This output signal is what? Which is inverting the same here also here. Means the output is same because 0 degree phase shift. It is not inverting here. So the input signal and this output signal, what happens? This is in positive side, this is in negative side. Means out of phase. Out of phase. This is what negative feedback. When the input is given to the amplifier, so after amplification gives the output value here, which is introducing the 180 degree phase shift, the signal should be in inverting. Okay. And the part of signal is fed into the input through the feedback network. So we are introducing 0 degree phase shift, means here there is a no change in the signal here, not inverting here. So we getting the inverted signal, which is out of phase with the input signal. This is out of phase with the output signal. This is what the negative feedback. In positive feedback, the input signal and the output signal, which are in phase with each other. So the input signal is and output signal are added, then the input signal should be increases. But here what happens? The input signal and output signal are out of phase. Here the input signal should be reduces. Input signal should be reduces. This is what the negative feedback. So the advantages of negative feedback are advantages of negative feedbacks. Reduction in the distortion. In the positive feedback, there will be a more distortion, and here what there is a reduction in distortion. Reduction in distortion, that may be harmonic, phase, amplitude or frequency. So, and highly stabilized gain. The gain should be very highly stabilized. Means there is a no formation of more noise. That should be clear. Whatever we getting the output should be clear. That is high stabilized gain. Increased the bandwidth. Increases the bandwidth. That is improved the frequency response. Improved frequency response. Improve the frequency response. And input and output impedance can be modified as desired. Whatever we have to give, that should be modified. We have to modify that as a desired. Whatever we want, that input and output signal should be we getting here. So reduction in the noise. Reduction in the noise. Reduction in noise. And increased circuit stability. Increased circuit stability. Circuit stability. These are the advantages of a negative feedback. The negative feedback advantages are more than the positive feedback. So what is the disadvantage here? In the circuits, it reduces the gain of an amplifier. Because here there will be a input signal and output signal are out of phase with each other. So it reduces the whatever the gain is, input signal and output signal gain is there, no? Output divided gain is what? Output by input. So which are in out of phase means what? Input signal which reduces the gain of an amplifier. So this one of the disadvantages of an negative feedback. So the positive feedback, which is having a, which is a this the positive feedback and negative feedback comparison, there will be negative feedback is what better. So the next one is gain of an amplifier. So how to calculate the gain of an feedback amplifier? The first one we have to calculate for the without feedback, the gain of an amplifier without feedback. without feedback. Without feedback means here. So if we give an input to the amplifier, here there will be we getting that is the output V naught. So this is without feedback. We not giving the output signal to the input. This is a without feedback. So that is the gain of an amplifier is given as output divided by input. The output voltage divided by input voltage. So this is what gain. So this is without feedback. So next one is with the feedback. Second one is with feedback. With feedback. With feedback. So the input signal is given to the amplifier. The output is getting here, and the part of the output is given to the input signal through the feedback network, which is given by gain, that is beta. So this is input signal, that is Vi. So here what happens when the for positive feedback, what happens? The input signal is equal to Vi plus Vf. Here there is a feedback voltage plus Vi. We getting the input signal that is added here. Means the output, say part of the output signal and input signal are added. Vi plus Vf. And in the case of negative feedback, positive feedback this one. In the case of negative feedback, the input signal should be Vi minus Vf. What is Vf here? What is Vf? Vf means this voltage, feedback voltage is given by beta into voltage, output voltage. Beta into output voltage is what? Feedback voltage. Vf is equal to beta into output voltage. So let us study the gain of an amplifier here. For a positive feedback, what happens? For positive feedback, so the gain is given by, that is what? AVF. The gain is equal to, or also first of all you find the gain is equal to output voltage divided by input voltage. Output voltage divided by input voltage is for without feedback. Okay, which is for a without feedback. Now you should write what is V naught is V naught. VIN is for positive feedback is what? Vi plus Vf. Then what is Vf? Beta into V naught. So Vi plus beta into V naught. Av is equal to V naught divided by Vi plus beta into V naught. This is for positive feedback. This is for positive feedback. So for negative feedback, V naught divided by Vi minus beta into V naught. This is for negative feedback. So let us take this value here, that is Av is equal to Av multiply, that is the Av into this term, Av into Vi plus Av into beta V naught is equal to V naught. the gain AV here. So AV into VI, AV into beta V naught and V naught. So take here the V naught common term. So keep this value here only. AV VI is equal to V naught minus AV beta into V naught. So take a common V naught here, both side. So 1 minus beta into AV. So this is AV VI. So here you take AV divided by this term. AV divided by 1 minus beta into AV, which is equal to here there is a remaining V naught here and divided by VI. So what is this V naught by VI is what? Gain. The output voltage divided by input voltage should be, the output voltage divided by input voltage should be gain. So AV divided by 1 minus beta into AV. So here output voltage divided by input voltage is a gain, but this is for with feedback, means we have to write here there is a AVF, that is what, with feedback. If there is a only AV means without feedback. If there is a AVF means with feedback, which is given by AV divided by 1 minus beta into AV. So this is for the equation for the gain of an feedback amplifier with feedback, for a positive feedback. For the positive feedback, we getting here the input signal, the both input and output should be added here, but the last equation came AV divided by 1 minus beta of AV, which is equal to AVF. Here AVF, if there is a for positive feedback, AVF is greater than without feedback gain. AVF means the gain with feedback is greater than the gain without feedback in this case of a positive feedback. Let us see the for negative feedback, that is the same equation is given by AV divided by 1 plus beta of AV. So if came here AV divided by 1 minus beta of AV means what? This is what? So see here, AV divided by 1 minus beta of AV is equal to AVF. AVF is greater than AV means what? The gain with the feedback is greater than gain without feedback, which is for the positive feedback. So here AV divided by 1 minus beta of AV. And what about negative feedback? AV divided by 1 plus beta of AV. This is for negative feedback. So which is equal to AVF, which is for negative feedback. This is for negative feedback. In this case, AVF means the gain with feedback is less than the gain without feedback. For the negative feedback, the gain with feedback is less than the gain without feedback. So here there is a gain should be decreases. Here gain should be decreases. And in the positive feedback, gain should be increases. So this is about the transfer gain of an feedback amplifier, which derivation for 5 marks, also 10 marks. So which is the important derivation you should do. And this is the gain of an amplifier with the feedback.